I had just wrapped up another grueling day at the office. It was past midnight and I was dead tired. Living alone in my small apartment had its perks, but on nights like this, it felt kind of lonely. My stomach grumbled, and I decided to treat myself to a late-night meal delivery. The thought of a hot, greasy burger sounded like the perfect end to my day. I grabbed my phone and placed an order. The estimated delivery time was 30 minutes, so I decided to read my book. As I was about to open the book, my phone buzzed with a message. It was the delivery guy, informing me that he was outside. That was fast. I left my book and hurried to the door. When I opened it, I was met with a tall, lanky guy in a delivery uniform. He held a bag with my food and gave me a smile that was just a little too wide. "Hey there, Sophia," he said, as if he already knew my name. "Hi," I mumbled, suddenly feeling a bit uneasy. Maybe it was the late hour, or perhaps his overly friendly demeanor, but something felt off. I tried to brush it off as me being paranoid and handed him the money for the food. But instead of leaving, he looked down at the bag and said, "You know, we've had some mix-ups lately. Mind if I come in and double-check your order?" "It won't take long, I promise." I hesitated for a moment, thinking about the safety of letting a stranger into my dimly lit apartment. "Well, can't you just check it here? I'm kind of in a hurry," I said. He insisted, "It'll just take a second, I promise. I want to make sure everything's perfect for you." Still feeling a little awkward, I opened the door wider, allowing him to step inside. I decided to keep a safe distance from him, hovering near the entrance. He placed the bag on the kitchen counter and began unpacking the contents. He seemed overly meticulous, double-checking each item, which only made my unease grow. As he rummaged through the food, I noticed something odd about him. His hands were trembling, and his eyes darted around the room as if he were looking for something other than my order. My heart began to race, and I took a step back. "I think everything is fine," I stammered, trying to sound calm. "You can go now." He didn't respond, continuing to inspect the food as if he hadn't heard me. It was at that moment that a feeling of dread washed over me. This situation was spiraling out of control, and I needed to act fast. I reached for my phone, planning to call the police. But as I did, he turned to me with a sinister grin. "Sophia, you should be more careful, letting strangers into your home." I froze. How did he know my name? My mind raced, trying to come up with a plan to escape this situation. I glanced at the front door, but he was blocking my way. With a sudden burst of adrenaline, I darted toward the kitchen, knocking the bag of food off the counter in the process. The clattering of containers hitting the floor echoed through the apartment. I grabbed a knife from the drawer, not knowing if I'd ever need it, and backed myself into a corner. The delivery guy's grin faded as he looked at the knife in my hand, and he began to step cautiously towards the door. "I didn't mean any harm," he stammered. "I'll just leave." I didn't let my guard down until he was safely outside. I locked the door behind him, my hands still trembling. It was only then that I realized the severity of what had just happened. He knew my name. He had been in my apartment, and his intentions were far from innocent. I called the police and recounted the terrifying experience. They assured me they would investigate and advised me to be cautious in the future. That night, I couldn't sleep, replaying the events in my head, grateful that my instincts had kicked in just in time to prevent a potential nightmare. The incident served as a stark reminder of the world's dangers, especially for someone living alone. From that day on, I made sure to double-check my safety measures and never let a stranger into my home, no matter how friendly they seemed. The simple act of ordering food had turned into a harrowing ordeal, one that would haunt my nightmares for a long time to come.
Subscribe for more videos.